Hey, this is Ralph, and in this video I want to use Microsoft Excel in order to calculate GPA for the term and for the entire year. So I've got an Excel spreadsheet already kind of started here, and my particular school uses terms, but the same process would be done if you're on semesters. So basically I've got several terms set up. I need to populate some course names. I'll just use generic filler names, and the letter grade earned, the number of credits for those particular classes, and then we'll come back and we'll figure out the points and the quality points. So let's take care of a few things. Okay, so I've created a kind of a mock schedule for the year. I've put in some courses, and very important, I've recorded some letter grades, and I've recorded the number of credits for each of those courses. You need to keep track of the number of credits for the particular class, because a 5-credit course is going to carry more weight in your GPA than a 2-credit course. Now the next thing I need to do is to populate the points, and this is going to be different for every school. You'll find it in your college catalog, but basically for each letter grade, there's going to be a certain number of points possible. For instance, an A is often going to be 4 points. Now, to make my life a little bit easier in entering these in, I'm going to go ahead and create a table off to the side to keep track of letter grades and points. Okay, so now I've got this little table up here. I've got a table of letter grades, and I've got a table of grade points. Now, these are not even the grade points for my school, because I want my students to look those up in the college catalog, but it's easy enough to replace these into your spreadsheet. Now for the points area for each term, I'm going to create a VLOOKUP function. And for my first one here, I'll just do equals VLOOKUP. My lookup value is going to be the letter grade for the particular class, comma. The table array, I'm going to go ahead and select my table array. Notice I'm getting everything, the letter grades right down there. I'm going to press my F4 key, function 4 key, to make this an absolute cell reference. Comma. Now for the column index number, I'm going to type in a number 2 because the grade points are in the second column of my 2-column table array. Comma, and then I'm going to do a false here. I'm typing in false because I want an exact match. Sometimes with a VLOOKUP, you'll want a value that's in between certain ones, but I want an exact match, so I am using false. I can do a closing parentheses and press enter. Now that that first one is done, I can auto-fill it down and see how it works. I'm going to go ahead and copy that and paste it to my others and make sure I get them all. There we go. Press escape to deselect. And now I can just kind of look at a couple. I see that an A minus is 3.7. That looks good. A B minus is 2.8. A's are 4s. And I do have an issue here. Now, although an F should be worth 0, for instance, if I go to one of these particular grades and I change this C plus to an F, I do want to see those points change to 0. However, courses that have a pass or a no pass or that a student withdraws from technically should not be a 0. They should be a blank. They're not going to factor in, and there's something we're going to have to take care of for those. So for these three, I'm just going to go ahead and type a space for each of them, hence some of these have a numeric value, now some of these have a blank text or null value, and you'll see that that impacted right there in the points column. Next is to calculate quality points, and this is going to be pretty easy here. I just go and take my quality points are going to be my credits times the number of grade points for a particular class. And then I can bring these down, and in fact I'll go ahead and copy that and paste and paste. Now you can see I've got a few little mess ups here because I'm trying to multiply a number by a null value or text. So I'll just go ahead and delete those particular items right there. If we want to be a little fancier, we could incorporate an if function into this formula, so that way we'd automatically get a blank there. Kind of a good way to go, but I'm not going to do that in this video. Now to finish this off, I want to get the sum of some areas, so I'm going to go ahead and sum up my credits. So I'll just click on the cell beneath this sum of credits, type a sum function in, add those up, and even though I think I'll just bring this over, do the same kind of thing, but I don't need points. And then I can copy this formula, paste, and paste, and let me go ahead and just change the fill color on these so they stand out to us. Okay, now to calculate the GPA for the particular term. Now, I do have a little mistake in here that's going to affect it, but it's an easy fix. And this part's going to be pretty easy. My GPA, I'll go ahead and put my GPAs right over here. This is simply going to be equal to my total quality points divided by my total credits. And so for this particular term, fall of 2019, my GPA is 3.038. However, I do need to fix this up because a P grade, a pass grade, is not factored into the GPA. Now, I took care of the quality points. There's no quality points, but there should also be no credits recorded either. I don't want to type a zero in. I'm just going to go ahead and do a space and an enter. And so now that GPA is improved to 3.59, and that is more accurate. And now that I've got that formula, I can go ahead and copy this and paste it to several others. And let's go ahead and make these all the same number of decimals. So now I start to have a better understanding of what's going on with each term's GPA. So now I just need to clean up a few of these others. Now for the F, I'm not going to do any deletions here because that F does earn zero. So an F has a tremendous impact on the GPA. But down here in this last term, the pass and the withdrawal, those credits really shouldn't be counted. So since I only had two classes with true credits that lead to true quality points, that's a 4.0 because both of my classes got an A in there, and those are 4 points each. So now that we've got those pieces of information, now we can do a much better total GPA. And for my total GPA, I'm going to go right down here, and this is going to be equal to the sum of all of my quality points. So I'm just going to go ahead and click on the first cell, comma, second, comma, third. So basically I'm summing non-contiguous cells there, and I'm going to divide that by the sum of the credits. I'll click on the first one, comma, the second one, comma, the third one, closing parentheses. So basically I'm doing the sum of all the quality points divided by the sum of all the credits. And that's going to give me an honest course, college GPA. In this case, I've got 3.23. And we can see that, okay, that's where that impact is coming from. So that's how we're going to calculate GPA. Basically, we need to know the credits for the classes. We need to know the points from our college catalog for the individual courses. Quality points are credits times the points. And then our GPA for a particular term is the sum of the quality points divided by the sum of the credits for that particular term. And for the overall GPA, it's the sum of all of the quality points for all terms divided by the sum of all of the credits for all the terms. Keep in mind, depending on your school, courses that get a pass or a no pass or a withdrawal or an audit, I should have had an audit on here as well, those courses generally do not factor into your GPA. So take care.